Good day from Chem Help ASAP. I've said that most inhibitors that are used as drugs are competitive reversible inhibitors. Why is this? When a discovery group targets an enzyme, they normally know the role of the enzyme. They know the substrate and product of the enzyme. For an enzyme, if you know the substrate, then you have a good idea of what kind of structure binds the active site of the enzyme. This kind of structural information is extremely valuable for the discovery team. The idea is to design an inhibitor that is structurally similar to the substrate, but lacks the functional groups that are reacted by the enzyme. Note that enzymes are generally easier to crystallize and get X-ray structures for. The X-ray structures are also super helpful for insight on the structure of the binding pocket and promising features for the inhibitor. So these are some of the advantages of going after competitive reversible inhibitors. The nature of enzyme chemistry can make these types of inhibitors more available. That does not mean that other types of inhibitors are bad or less effective. Let's see a couple examples of enzyme substrates and then inhibitors that have been developed that are strikingly similar to the substrate. In this first example, the enzyme in question is adenosine deaminase. The substrate is adenosine, and the chemical reaction occurs at this carbon at the top of the molecule. The nitrogen is ultimately replaced by an oxygen. An inhibitor for this enzyme is pentostatin, shown in the bottom right. Pentostatin is very similar to both the substrate and product, but the ring is bigger. Shouldn't do that as a circle, it looks aromatic. It's bigger by one atom, and there is an alcohol on the key reaction carbon. Pentostatin is used to treat certain forms of cancer. In the second example, the enzyme is 4-hydroxyphenylpyruvic acid. The enzyme is 4-hydroxyphenylpyruvate dioxygenase. It performs a decarboxylation and an oxidation of the substrate. Nitazinone is a competitive reversible inhibitor for the enzyme. It doesn't completely resemble either the substrate or product. The similarity increases once you consider the charge of the molecules. Both the substrate and the product have negative charges at physiological pH from carboxylic acids. The inhibitor does not have a carboxylic acid, but the pKa of this proton is extremely low, and it is deprotonated at biological pH. The conjugate base of the inhibitor is an anion, just like the substrate and product. And yet the inhibitor lacks the reactive carboxylic acid group that we see in the substrate. Nitazinone is used as to treat a rare metabolic disorder in which patients cannot properly metabolize tyrosine. As always, thank you for watching. Ask any questions below, and please consider subscribing and leaving a like. Take care.